close to him.
Okay. So that's what we're looking at, and then let me freehand this in red. There's like a... Nope, that's blue. It's fine. That's the bonfire. So as I understand it, Santino's like over here. We'll just say he's there. Devona, you were on a rooftop, like here-ish. Jin's charging in. And John, where were you? Just move yourself wherever you were.
Where is the crowd?
The crowd is all around.
I mean, I was kind of in the middle of the crowd, I think. Or toward the back of it, maybe.
It's kind of...
Oh, do I need to do turn order?
Yeah, we'll get to that. That's the crowd, and then let me put the guys out. I had said originally that there were like eight, right?
No, you. Yeah, I think there was like four or five.
Like, it was just two guys. It was just two guys.
Shut up, John.
I think it started off at 12, and then it came down a little bit to like, I think, four or five.
Because some were handling the crowd.
Yeah, I think there was like two on the crowd. There was the one preaching and then two flamethrowing things. So
here, the one that's preaching is going to be represented by an ogre. Fun.
And I was standing right next to him, or at least charging towards him. So yeah.
Okay.
The two guys with the flamethrowers.
A few guys that are just throwing shit in the fire, and then two more handling the crowd. And then Jin, you're charging at him. And John, you're like in the crowd. And
there was one that was holding Endemar and one that was holding Aaron and Ella.
Right. I'm going to put that. I had originally envisioned that here. No, here. Sorry. I had a very specific mental image in mind. Okay. So, anyway, let's roll for initiative, huh?
Oh, boy. what the heck did we get ourselves into?
All right, John is at 19. Let me also roll for myself. Make sure to select your token before you roll.
Ooh, 25.
Height 25. All right. What is the combatant's initiative? Let's see.
If he tries to hit me, I'm gonna get angry. I'm gonna go all Hulk on his rear end.
Ooh, not great. Not great. Okay, and then for the separate one, that is...
is this guy over here the leader? Father, what's his face?
Brother Pietro?
Yeah.
No, this is Brother Pietro.
He's
getting his own initiative roll.
See, I was aiming at him the entire time.
Okay. And I'm going to use Santino's token to represent his initiative role. Just because I don't feel like using myself again.
Okay. So he's going to control him like yourself?
Santino? He's just not taking part in the fight. All right, so...
Pansy.
I'm going to put everyone in neutral. I'm going to put Santino in full defense. But he is still open to attack. Okay. There's no surprise. Declare your stance. So, everyone, declare your stance. Jin, are you...
I'm going to go neutral.
Okay. So, John, the last thing that you had done was... do you want to do that before or after Jin charges in to attack?
Sort of as he is.
Okay, so we'll do it on your initiative turn. All right, so Jin, you're up first. What are you doing? Actually, wait, before you do that, let me grab my notepad so I can keep a note of what's going on. Because I find that's good. Okay, go ahead. Jin, hello?
Oh, sorry. Okay, so I charged at the guy, right?
Mm-hmm. Are you literally charging? Are you gonna hit him?
Is he like, how's he responding to me?
He hasn't really reacted as of yet. He's still preaching and yelling about how tech is evil.
Should we check him into the fire?
You know, that's a good idea. I'm going to run, and I'm going to just full-on shoulder bash the guy.
Okay.
Like, I don't want to, like, actually attack him yet, but I want to get his attention.
Knock down or knock out? Look at the bottom.
Let's see.
What I'm asking is, are you looking more to damage him, or are you just trying to knock him straight up, knock him into the fire?
I'm going to straight up knock him out.
Knock out? That's more about hurting them. Knock down is more about like getting them down and making them more vulnerable to damage.
Well, it looks... Well, knockdown would be getting more vulnerable. Knockout would be like literally knocking him out, right?
Knock down, you're pushing him into the fire. Knock out, you're trying to hurt him.
I'm just going to try and knock him out.
All right. So then that's an opposed roll of dexterity and melee or... dexterity or melee. No, sorry. Melee or fight to choose.
I bet you didn't.
I'm going
to
do dexterity plus melee.
So what is that for you?
That's 8 plus... 7. 8 plus 7, 15.
Cool. So roll that.
Okay. So slash roll d20. Yes. That was 14. Close.
Nice. So that translates to 7 VP for you. And let me. So now I have to make my endurance and vigor. So endurance is 7 and vigor is 6, which is 13 total. Ah, what just happened? My bot just wired. Ah,
yes!
Okay. Damn it!
He almost critically failed, too.
If he critically failed, it's over. Okay. So...
like, that means I literally just... literally knocked his... yeah.
Attacker,
I may have just knocked his head off with my shoulder.
Attacker must do more damage than half of the target's endurance. They must oppose the roll and do it twice. If they reach critical vitality, they take damage equal to half of the wound points. Non-lethal attacks can have wounds converted to VP. Okay, so that would you're just shoulder checking him. How does that convert in damage? Let me check that. Combat. One moment. Grapple, knock down, knock out. Okay. Oh, it's a minus 4 for you also, so that's actually a 10, which makes it 5 VP, but it's fine. Oh no, that's still a... oh no, Jin, you failed, because it was it's a demanding task. It's a minus 4 penalty.
Man.
Which means that the goal roll was actually 11. Doesn't matter, we both failed. Okay, so...
so we knock into each other and... yeah.
Basically, you got his attention... good for you, but more or less, you just kind of knocked into him, and he like regained his stance, and you got knocked down a little bit, but you're fine too. In which case, all right, moving forward.
Just one big oomph.
Yeah. Devona,
all right, give me make a move. So I am going to aim at Father Pietro.
Cool. So you're just going to aim another turn?
No, I'm sorry. I mean, I'm taking my turn of aiming at him, so I'm going to fire.
Okay. So then that makes your goal roll 20, right?
Yep.
Cool. 17. So that's going to be 8 VP for you. Oh, nice. Okay, so now I'll roll the damage for your gun.
Let's see. I think my gun...
oh, and we've been... and also, I meant to mention this to you guys. I was rereading the rules, and I think I've been completely fucking it up because... I guess I've been making combat less deadly overall. Doesn't really matter because we've done it for both. But I do believe that actually it's not fives and sixes, but one through fours that are successes.
Yeah, I actually read that like 2 days ago myself.
Yeah, rolls of 1, 2, 3, and 4 are successful, while 5 and 6 are failures. So, and since we've been doing that with everything, it's better. Like, we've been doing it with armor and damage, but now we're going to do it that way. So, right. Roll your damage, and 1 through 4 is what you want.
Yeah, let me just check again to see what my gun is.
Also, Liam, for reference, yes. I also read that I should be getting a +1 damage on all my melee attacks because of my 8 strength.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Nice. All right, I'm sorry that I missed that.
Worst period GM period ever. Period. Oh.
Devona, what are we talking in? How many dice?
Hang on, let me find my gun.
Okay.
Okay, it's 8 dice. It's normally 6, but since I'm in aggressive stance...
Who you aiming at? Are you aiming at the leader, dude?
Pietro. Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 successes.
Gosh.
That's 13. And
but
then...
if he had an energy shield, it's not going to keep.
Oh, no, it's not. But it doesn't really matter because he doesn't have one. Okay. So... Oh man, it's not looking good for Brother Pietro. Holy shit.
Wait, that's 6 successes, right? I'm sorry.
That is 6, yeah, because it's 1, 2, 1, 1, 2. That's 13 minus his defense of 1.
What's his armor?
Well, and let me roll his armor right now. What is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 successes. Makes it a 7. Took out his defense. All right, so he takes a whopping 7 damage. Wow. Okay, so that's like a shot to the jaw. You take a nice hearty shot and it just strikes him right in the jaw, almost knocks it clean off, and he falls to the ground. You shut him up for a while. We'll put it that way. He's not preaching the evils of tech for a hot second anymore.
Oh, speaking of that, did you read?
Is he dead?
No.
What the fuck?
That's unfortunate.
I can tell you, he's probably critical.
I was asking if he was dead.
Devona, what did you say?
Did you read the Discord about my stance on the church, Devona's stance on the church, and why they don't like each other?
I don't know why so you believe in God, but you don't believe in specifically the church.
Well, the church basically preaches the opposite of what she believes in, because she's been exploring the galaxy, and she's like, there's no way that this was just man-made. This had to have been God creating the tech and giving it to man.
So you're still religious, you're just not church religious. I get it. You're kind of like Solomon Cain like that.
Yeah, so she believes the opposite of what the church is teaching. She thinks that God gave the technology ideas to mankind and the other alien races.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so...
So she thinks technology is a gift of God, while the church believes technology is a sin.
Got it. Okay. So, moving on. John, it's your turn.
All right, so this is when I would throw my fate grenade, right?
The power cell.
Yeah.
Are you throwing it into the fire or where?
Just kind of at the fire, yeah. I'm not trying to hit anything, just, you know. I'm just trying to throw something and yell grenade to see if I can make people, like, scatter or hit the ground or something.
So it's just a completely random throw in that general direction.
Exactly.
Okay, so it's kind of important where it lands. I'm going to have you roll 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so if you look, I'm marking it. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So roll a D16 for me, because we can do that in roll 20 to see where it lands, since you're just lobbing it.
See if it lands in the fire.
Okay. And then 13. The fire something explodes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. It lands right here. Okay. It was me just checking if it lands in the fire. Because if it lands in the fire, it does actually explode.
And in my best, you know, sergeant-y voice, loud and angry sounding, I yell, grenade.
Okay. So at the yell, grenade, the entire crowd, which is already pretty loud, John's voice pierces through, and a shriek is heard from all directions as most of the crowd dives away from the fire. And the Avestites, mostly dive away with the crowd as well. The one that Jin had knocked down is pulled away by one of the other Avestites that was by the fire.
The one that got his jaw shot off.
Yeah, he pulls him away. So I'm just going to move everyone generally away. Jin, do you move or what? I'm assuming you haven't conferred with John, so you wouldn't know.
I was about to ask, yeah, is there a way for me to know if it's a ruse or not? Like, catching what it is out of the corner of my eye or something, would I have to roll that?
You can roll and observe, but then if you're going to roll observe, I'm also going to roll the Avestites as well. Do you want to do it?
No, I'm just going to, like, go to one knee and face away from it.
Okay. So
like getting really small.
Got it. Okay, so John, you throw your power cell and yell, grenade! And the next turn is all... The next... Everything is just all of them fleeing. So then, Jin, it's back to you.
And they're all kind of prone right now, aren't they?
Most of them have, like, ducked to the ground or are just running away.
Beautiful.
So, Jin, it's you. And right now... Now would be the time to figure out if it's actually a grenade or not. I would not make it cost a turn for you or anything. It would just be like glancing over to see what it is.
Okay, I'll do that.
Okay, so then that's perception observe.
Hold on, let me see. Perception is 6. Observe is 3. I need to get less than a 9. Yoo-hoo!
Nice.
Okay. So I know it's not a grenade.
You notice that it's not a grenade.
So now that I know that it was a distraction, let's see. How far can I charge?
5 squares.
Like, what's my range?
5 squares.
So, like that? Wait, that would be that much. So 25 feet, basically.
Yeah.
That's 5 squares.
Yeah, you could do that. But you'd have to go around the fire, obviously.
I'm going to charge at that guy. And as I run towards him, I'm going to like wave up toward Devona and point at the guy who's dragging Petra away. It's like, as I'm running...
This guy.
I'm gonna point to this guy.
Okay, and what
like
are you
basically telling her, shoot him, and then I slice at this guy.
Okay, so give me a good melee and dex roll.
Of course. Wonderful melee and dex.
Everyone's favorite.
That's a 15. I know that's a 15.
A classic. 20.
Wasn't a fail.
No, it wasn't. That's a skin of your teeth.
I hit the guy.
That's a meat off the bat. No victory points. Give me your damage roll.
That is... It's a D8 for my thing, right?
8D. So 8D6.
Yeah, 8D. And that's D6?
Yes.
8D6.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nice. Okay, the natural defense makes it a 4. And then I'll roll his armor, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, that's unfortunate.
Oh, he matched me.
He matched you. So you slice at him, and he just like uses one of his gauntlets and just bats your Naginata away from him. And I'm actually gonna go back a turn to mine. Again, just get this. I forgot to do one quick thing. It doesn't really affect what just happened, though. I'm going to take an action for Aaron and Ella and Enomar, deciding whether or not they notice what's up with the grenade, because they know that John would try some bullshit like that.
Hey, it worked.
Hey, so, if it's stupid and it works, then it ain't stupid, right?
That's true. So Endemar is the only one of these actual skills, but I'm going to use his for all three of them. So he has perception of 4 and an observe of 5, so that's 9. Not at all. All right. Just wanted to see if that would work. Anyway, moving on. Devona, it's your turn.
All right. So Jin is pointing to shoot this guy.
Yes.
The guy that Jin told you to?
Yeah. Well, if Father Pietro's pretty much disabled for right now, she's going to actually go for it.
All right, so that's a 19, right?
18.
Ooh! That was my roll, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no.
I just looked over and I saw an 18, and I was like, ha! Huh. All right, not bad. So that's a 5. Give me the damage roll.
That is 7.
Can that guy's armor even get that much?
No, it can't. He has a -1 for his defense, and then slash R. -1, -2, -3, -4, -5. Brings it down to 6. All right, so I'm just marking this down here. How much damage did you take? 7. Okay, I'm sorry. And 6. Okay, so that's like a good shot in the back, and it knocks him to the ground, maybe unconscious. You can't really tell at the moment. There's too much happening. The fire kind of blazes up in your way, and you can't see quite as well what's going on over there. John, it's your turn. How much damage did you do? 6.
Oh, okay.
Okay, is it -1 or -2 for each additional action attack?
Hmm?
-2.
Is it?
Your gold number drops by 2 if you're doing both attacks.
Right, so I could do like 3, but the second or the third one would be at -4, right?
Yes.
You roll it all at once.
The whole roll would be at a -4.
Gotcha. Okay, so the guy that's in front of me, I can't figure out how to make it like ping on the map, but
you hold the closest down.
You hold down.
That guy? Yeah, right there.
Yeah.
That guy. I'm going to make an attempt to stab him twice.
Okay, so that would be a -2 for multiple attacks. And you offset the offhand thing, right? Because of your fighting stance?
Not only that, well, I do, but also with the ambidexterity, but also if I'm using my offhand weapon, he gets a -2 to defense.
Ooh, alright. So, he's going to take... Okay, cool. So he's getting a -2 to defense. So now roll at a -2. So what's your goal number?
15.
So it would normally be a 17.
Yes, it would normally be a 17, but it's 15 with the -2.
Got it. Cool. All right, so that's 7 right off the bat. Roll your damage for the trench knife +1 +1D or just +1 because of your strength?
Just +1. I don't know, actually.
You roll. I'll check that out.
Okay.
Oh, it's right here. it's just add one effect die, so roll one more d6.
Now I'm going to roll twice for damage because I'm doing two knives or what?
Wait, actually, what is up with that? No, you roll once and then you split it between multiple people, but it's not... Wait, hold on a second.
No, I think you roll it for each...
That's for... I was thinking of multiple shots. I'm sorry. Let me check the...
Well, multiple shots, I think you roll it the damage of each weapon at multiple times as well.
Once characters are in a grapple, no, that's not it. Benefit of special effects, so... I'm looking at the rule book. I'm sorry. One sec. Penalty the same. No. It says you can mix attacks, but the penalties are the same, and the character must use the lower. Once the goal roll is made, victory points are split as evenly as possible between the two attacks, with the attacker deciding where the remainder goes. Also, the only way it gets split is a multiple attack over two targets. The only way they can split a multiple attack over two targets is if both targets are adjacent to them. Doesn't say, so I'm going to say roll twice, yeah.
All right, so I'm going to roll 4d6. That's my knife plus the strength, and then we're going to add one because of the trench knife gets a plus one.
Nice. And you're rolling this twice, so 4d6 two times. 1, 2, 3, plus one is four. And 1, 2, plus one is three.
I'm going to use a point of word to re-roll that second one.
Okay, go ahead. That's four, all right.
It's actually five.
Right, because of the one more. So that's... Oh, mama. Okay. And then I'm going to roll
his... 16, I think, total?
I'm just going to... Give me a second here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Down. To there. All right. So...
I think he's dead, though.
You're charging forward and attacking him, right?
I mean, is it really a charge to move, like, 5 meters?
Not really, but like, you know, stepping out of the crowd and just like putting your knives
stepping into out of the him. Crowd, gutting him like a fish. Yeah.
All right. So I'm just going to do that and I'm put you there. And you can go ahead and stylize however the hell you want. Tell us what you do.
All right. I step in front of him and with my dominant hand, my right, I just slash across his throat and then kind of drop down a little bit and come back up and bring my other knife like into his gut and just yank up like I'm field dressing a deer or something.
Ooh. That is really good. All right. You know what's weird too? Because your picture, I don't know. I haven't looked at your picture closely. All right. Doesn't really look like him, but for some reason, like in my head, I've just based on your picture. And then I just kind of like didn't look at it again. Way I picture John is as like a really buff Dave Chappelle, if you can picture that. So I just picture like a really buff Dave Chappelle stepping out of a cloud and out of a crowd and just like, and just like slicing a man open like a deer. That's really funny.
Because I'm Wayne Brady, bitch.
It's a great mental image. I'll say that much. So anyway,
So I'm assuming he's done, though, that guy.
Yeah. No, he's donezo. He's completely done.
One down. Yeah,
missed a clean kill. Okay, so skip over Santino.
Six to go, I think.
Oh, no. Skip over. So go to Santino. Yeah, that's not actually Santino. That's Brother Pietro. Honestly, I'm just going to get rid of that because it goes... Since he's next to the other guys, they all go at the same time. So... Brother Pietro, where is he at on his health? He needs to make a roll to see if he stays conscious. So, where are we here?
The man had shut off.
Yeah, no, he needs to just, we need to figure out if he's staying conscious. Endurance and vigor, that's a 13. He is not conscious. All right, cool. So anyway, for everyone else.
For the record, Devona, that doesn't count because he's not dead yet. I'm still up.
So, how do we want to... All right, let me think about how I'm going
to
do this.
What about this guy? Doesn't he need to make a roll to see if he's conscious?
No, he's unconscious.
Oh, they're both off?
I mean, you can't really tell if he is, but he is unconscious. Just given the amount of damage you did to him, you can kind of infer that he's at the least unconscious, if not dead.
All right. So if I were to use my next round to, like, double-tap both of them, do I need a rolls?
Yes.
Okay.
But I have a plan, Devon.
Okay, I'm gonna first make a roll for Aaron, Ella, and Endemar, just for the three of them, to see if they can break the grapple using Endemar's stats.
He bites them.
Endemar's stats are not good. Alright, so...
He needs to bite attack.
A bite attack. Maybe go into a frenzy, you know?
Cannibal
so
frenzy.
Close to so much human flesh.
Can't handle it. He actually doesn't have a fight stat. So I'm just going to use... who would it make sense to use? It would make sense to... Aaron, I could probably most equate to a muster guy. So I'm going to use a muster stats. Strength of 7 and a fight of 6. So the goal is 13. Not that. All right. So he tries to break the grapple, entirely fails. It's fine. So the guy in front of you, Jin, is going to whip out his flamethrower, and he tries to, like, set you on fire full on. So he is going to roll a
D20. Please tell me I can dodge that.
No, not really. Sorry. Oh, so...
They didn't use flamethrowers the last time.
So he has a shoot of 6 and a dex of 4. The goal number is 10. Nope, he failed.
Yes.
Alright, so he pulls out his flamethrower and just starts like swoosh back and forth trying to hit you, and you you jump back, just teetering on the edge of the fire. Maybe like some of your wrappings like get a little, you know, they get a little ember on them, but you manage to regain your balance and stay strong.
Can I do a funny RP thing?
I got a question.
Can I do a funny role play thing?
Sure, sure.
Can I like do and like wag my finger in front of him like, uh-uh?
Yeah, sure.
Like, nice try, bro.
I got a question. What's the range of the flamethrowers?
The range of the flamethrowers is not very far, but it's pretty decent. I think it's about... Wait, let me see. I don't want to tell you the wrong number of meters.
Well, I think I see where Devon is going with this. What's the chances that with that close a range, he hits somebody else?
Yeah, that's what I was going with. Does he hit any of these guys right here?
Oh, it's not 25 feet. It's at most like 5 or 6 feet. All it's right. Pretty short.
Okay, so he doesn't even
He's hitting me in that kind of cone right there.
Pretty much, yeah.
But that means that none of the other guys have flamethrower range to me either. So
not as of right now, unless they run forward. The rest of them are kind of trying to incite the crowd. But John, you hear a voice cut above the crowd, and you recognize it as Aaron's. And you just hear him yell, "John, John, stir the people!" And he's yelling out as loud as he can, like, "Stir the people, get them going, like, get them fighting." Before he's silenced by the man that's holding him. So we're gonna cut forward. Jin, it is your turn.
Does it require an action to switch stances?
What?
Like, can I switch stances?
Now would be the time. If anyone wants to switch a stance, now is the time.
Okay, I'm gonna move into aggressive stance.
Also, John, this man charges forward towards you. And Jin, this man makes a move towards you. but they neither of them attack. Sorry, what are you doing to Jin?
Well, I'm going to go to aggressive stance.
Okay.
So. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to point again, because so far the sniper fire is working well. I'm going to point to this guy over here. Hang on. To this guy, if it will let me do it. Yeah, that guy.
Nope.
In the corner there.
Which one? Sorry, one more time.
That one.
Ah,
this
okay.
one over here. So I'm like directing the Overwatch type of thing for Devona, like saying, take that guy out.
We're actually looking at this. Sorry. This guy?
Yeah, the guy in the back.
Okay.
Or, you know, whichever she wants to take out first.
Got
and
it.
Then I'm going to take two actions, so I only get a plus two, right? Instead of a plus four for aggressive.
What are you doing? Are you trying to slash up both of these guys?
Well, what I wanted to do, I kind of want to get a little bit fancy, but I want to stand on my Naginata and kick at the one on my left and try to knock him down, and then go full out slash at the one on my right.
Ooh, nice.
So a nice 1-2 type thing.
Okay, so you're going to use fight for the left, and you're going to use melee for the right. Which one of them is lower, fight or melee?
Hang on, let me check. Where's my fight? Fight's lower.
Okay, so what's the total there?
So it's dexterity plus fight, that's 14, plus 2 from being aggressive, so 16.
Cool, roll it.
Slash roll d20. 7, yes.
Nice, okay, so that's going to convert to 3 VP. That's going to split into 1 for each. So
no, I'm only kicking at one. It's two separate actions.
I know, but the way it works is you make the roll and then you split the VP between the two actions. So you get one for each. It splits evenly, and then the remainder. So the last one, which one do you want to go with? The kick or the slash?
One more time.
So when you make the multiple actions roll, you split the VP between the two actions. So you have 3 VP, okay. So one goes to each of them, and then there's one left, and you decide where that one goes.
I'll take that one to the slash, the attack.
Got it. Okay, so now roll the damage for the kick, which is just melee damage. Let me tell you exactly. I'm telling you that right now. Give me a sec, because I'm actually not sure. No, I don't know.
Because if I can pull this off, that'd be really sick.
That would be really cool. Hold on. I'm just going to search unarmed damage in the PDF. No. What? Oh, it doesn't tell you what the damage unarmed is. Hold on. This is so annoying.
Would it be like strength or combat melee?
I'm not sure. Here we go. Low level general character. Blah, 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 blah. Extensive training, hand to hand combat, some martial arts. Nope, it doesn't say. Okay.
Well, if it's a knockdown, it does no damage. It just lowers his defense.
Yeah, but it doesn't say that. Were you just trying to knock him down? I thought you were trying to hurt him.
No, I was just trying to knock him down. I'm basically just kicking him down.
Oh.
It's like, get him out of the way.
In that case, he needs to make an opposed roll. He needs to... Okay, so that would be a... Dexterity and fight is what you used, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's a goal number of 10 for him. He gets one VP and does not succeed because you gave him one VP. So
I knock him down.
All right, so he loses two defense for the next turn.
So I literally just stand on my pole and kick him on his rear end.
Okay.
It's hard to describe, but I can visualize in my head because it's a For Honor move, but it's hard to describe.
No, I kind of see what you're saying. Okay, so he's not taking any damage. The other guy has two victory points looking his way, so roll your damage. Which I think is 8.
Okay. Yeah, it's 8 plus 2 dice, so 10 dice.
Got it.
10d6.
One, two, three, 7. 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow, all right. 7 minus his 1 defense is an 8. I'm going to roll his 76. 1, 2. Oh, those are all successes. All right. So you manage to slash across his stomach and like open, and it slices open his robes, and you cut and you draw a little blood. You can feel it, but not much. It was barely a scratch for him.
Oh, that lucky.
Let me mark that down.
Darn lucky.
Okay. Devona, your turn.
Alright, so Devona's really thinking she might shoot this guy since he's actually prone.
Which one? This one?
No, this one. The one that has negative 2.
Oh, that just got knocked down? Okay, can do that.
Yeah, she's kind of watching this, but she's also realizing that Jin will be in trouble if either of these guys uses flamethrower. But at the same time...
Well, then shoot the guy who's not on his back.
Stop! No metagaming.
Her real question is she's thinking, like, will these guys in the back actually risk setting their friends on fire?
One bit of lore I'm going to give you is that the Avestites are known for wearing flame retardant robes.
So they are probably going to risk it. So they probably will just blast all their friends in the back and hope that they survive.
You don't know, but I'm just letting you know. They wear flame retardant robes because they'd hurt themselves if they were using flamethrowers and weren't wearing flame retardant robes.
Alright, so I'm hitting this guy in the back.
Which guy? I'm sorry. Highlighted him again? Ah, okay. So you're looking at an 18?
Damn it.
Okay, so that's 3 victory points.
With all 8? So 11?
Oh, man. Okay. 11 minus 1 equals 10. And let me roll his. 1, 2. Okay, so just 6. Okay, so you fire and you hit him right in the hip. And it certainly gives him a run for his money. It knocks him down onto one knee in his hands. But he is still moving, and he seems to still be... He's taking out his flame gun as you are watching him.
I got a question. How big of an explosion would it be if I shot this guy in the back with his tank?
Really fucking big.
Really big? Okay. Because I was just wondering, because you said the flamethrowers were only 5 meters.
No. We're talking pretty big, because that's just a massive gas explosion.
Please don't incinerate our friends, Devona.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
I figured, don't have flame retardant stuff.
I figured Devona would understand how big of an explosion is if she shot the tanks and won't do it. I was just wondering if from my point of view, is it gonna be like a red barrel from an from Doom, or is it going to be more like a big blast?
Okay, so then we're going to moving on to John's turn.
Well, I say if it ain't broke, don't fix it. So I'm going to try and double tap this guy right in front of me.
All right. So that would be a 15 for
15,
you.
15, yeah. And I'm going to spend a point of word and re-roll that.
All right, so throw down another word.
That's going to be a I could have re-rolled something? Darn.
You have to spend a point of word to do it. That's 3 VP for you. Roll your damage. So that would be 4d6 two times plus one on each. That's plus 4. And do it again. Plus 5. 7, 12. So minus 1. Oh, no. It's your fighting style, right? Okay, so that makes it 13. And then 1, 2. Only 2 successes. Okay.
Okay.
He does get a minus 2 because of my fighting style, though.
Oh, I know. don't worry, I accounted. So, indulge us once again with how you just got this man.
All right, I will stick one of my dominant hand knife right into his throat, just straight on, like a lunge. And then, I guess the other one goes into his lower abdomen. And I'll slice across with it.
Cool. Okay. So he's down and out again. Blood spurts everywhere, and he drops to the ground.
And also, I want to yell something if I can.
Please, feel free.
I will, as I'm doing this, I will yell as loud as I possibly can. You know, rise up, slay them all, take no prisoners.
At the people, I assume?
Sure.
Sure. All right. So I think I have a list of skills here. There's a specific skill that corresponds to this. I've been thinking about it.
I'm sure it's presence in something.
No, I think it's called leadership, actually. Hold on. Let me pull it up in the PDF. Skills. There's a list of them in here somewhere. Here we go. Okay. So no. Yep, it's a social skill called leadership. So it would be your presence along with... Yeah, it would be your presence along with leadership. I'm assuming you don't really have leadership. It's a learned skill.
I do not have leadership.
So it's just your presence. And I'll give you a plus 3 to this because the Avestites are assholes.
And do not screw this up.
Right,
because so, maybe the people can charge these guys that are attacking me, and I won't get attacked.
What was your goal number?
8.
Cool. So you're good. Okay. So you shout out to the crowd, you know, take no prisoners, etc. And as you yell that, some of them that were still like cowering from the expected grenade to attack in the following fight, they surge forward, and I'm just going to take away one guy for each of your victory points. So you're going to get 2 guys taken out. So they surge forward and pull this guy away, and they pull this guy away. And as an added bonus, they manage to take out, as your little extra for your victory point, they manage to break free. Aaron manages to, in the ensuing chaos, Aaron managed to break free from the man that was holding him. And pulls a knife and starts fighting this one, who is still trying to hold on to Endemar and Ella. So I'm going to put a token.
Please tell me some of the Avestites turn around and start fighting the crowd.
That's what happened.
Extremely optimal.
That's what happened to those guys. The one that was here that was down just got straight up pulled away. Like, he's gone.
And like the chud came and got him?
Just the crowd overall just like pulled him away like in fury. And the other guy over here got pulled away as well. And Aaron broke free. That's what you're getting. So back to my turn. So Aaron is going to fight with the guy over here. I haven't actually taken the stats for him. I'm going to tweak the stats later, but for right now I'm still using the muster stats. So he's going to roll a d20, which is going to be strength and dexterity and melee, which is 11. So his goal number is 11. Wow. Okay. 0 VP. And he's going to roll the damage for a knife, which is 46. That's 4 successes. Nice. And then he's going to get to roll his 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so it evens out, and nothing happens. He slashes at this man, at the Avestite man, and they're trading blows. He's kind of dodging and putting Endemar and Ella in the way of him, and obviously Aaron is being careful and trying not to strike them, and so there's very little advance in either direction there. This man is going to run all the way over here, and you can see Devona doesn't see, but John, you do see that this man is making a break for it to try and climb up the rooftop and get to Devona. And we'll say he gets like halfway up the ladder or whatever he's climbing to get up there. He's climbing a storefront. He manages to like jump on some boxes and then climb onto an awning, and he's trying to climb up a window and over onto the rooftop. While these two that are in front of you, Jin, are trying to hit you. So I'm going to roll for them both.
Strike me or flame for me?
The one that's on the ground is just going to try and fire some flames at you, but this one is going to try and club you. Actually, no, they're both going to try and flame through you. What am I saying? They're Vestites. I'm a fool.
Does the one on the ground get a minus to anything?
Yeah, of course. Because
he's trying to shoot from the ground?
No, of course. He gets a minus two.
Hey, Jen, quick, change your avatar to a marshmallow.
Okay, so...
That would be putting myself in a very bad position.
I mean, you know, who knows? Who knows what'll happen? Anyway, where is this? Okay.
I'm assuming by now everyone's figured out that there's not really a grenade.
Oh, yeah, no, we all figured it out eventually. They got there. What is shoot for the... shoot is 6, dexterity 4. So the goal number is 10. I'm rolling it twice. Miss on that one.
Plus I have a minus 2 to defense right now.
It doesn't matter. They just both failed.
If they both miss, man, these guys suck.
They're just, you know, they're not having a great time. It's not been a good day for them, okay?
Well, it was up until, like, 20 minutes ago.
Yeah, they're having a great time burning some technology. Devon is, like, freaking out, twitching, like, ah.
Like, all no, right. Please, no, please, Jin, stop.
Jin, have at it.
Ha ha ha, my turn, boys. All right, so I'm going to go with a double move again. And I'm just going to straight out swipe at both of them.
All right, so it's just going to be 2 attacks?
Yeah. One guy's still on the ground, right?
Yeah, so you're looking at a 17 because you're in aggressive stance.
He didn't even try to get off? Man, this really, really suck.
I mean, he's on his ass trying to fire a flamethrower at him. At you. That was more of his goal. Your goal number is 17. Oh man, that's 8 VP, so it goes to 4 each. Roll your damage, which is a 10. 10d6. So roll that twice.
10d6. And slash roll 10d.
Oh wow. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That 1, 2, 3, 4, 7. Okay, so you get 11 on that one. Okay. What were you saying about minus 2 defense? That was your own defense. Got it.
Yeah, and the guy on the ground too.
Yeah, he's losing defense as well.
So he's gonna take a bonus 1 damage to whichever one hit him.
Of course. That's 10. Okay, I'm going to roll both of their armors. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 successes. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 successes again. Okay, so...
That's taking time, into account the one guy is -2, right?
Of course. This guy takes a much harder strike through from the Naginata. Both of them, actually. The one on the ground takes a much a pretty solid hit up like across the, his chest as he's trying to get up. And the other one just takes a solid slice across the stomach. Both of them are fully shocked at Jin's sudden lashing out, but neither of them are dead. Put it that way.
Into one and whip around and slash across the other.
They're not doing so hot, put it like that, but they are alive and they are still capable of a fight. I'm just making sure I still have.
Hopefully, Devonna can take one out. At least one out.
Hopefully. Sorry, I'm just marking my map here.
It's not my turn. I'll be right back. I'm gonna go get some food, so I'll be right back.
That's fair. Okay, there we go. All right, so Devona, it's your turn.
How hurt is this guy?
He's not in great shape, but he is certainly still in the. He's still gonna keep fighting. He's in a condition to keep fighting.
And what about this guy?
He's much worse. He's not dead, and he's not unconscious, but he is.
But he's suffering the -4 for critical.
He is suffering a. Not bonus, penalty. That's the word.
Yeah. All right, I'm gonna shoot this guy because I didn't.
Which one? I'm sorry. You can't see him. You didn't know.
I'm saying I'm shooting this guy because I didn't see the other guy sneak by me.
Got it. Okay, so
John will be there to protect me.
All right, she says.
That depends on how many firebirds you get.
Oh no!
I am gonna spend a wart to reroll that.
Alright, get at it. Alright, so that's gonna be 1 VP. Roll your damage of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
So 6 total.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
Yep,
okay, I'm back. Sorry about that.
Oh, well, that's unfortunate. So, you shoot him and it dings right off of the container on his back. And you see a worried expression cross his face as he was, like, almost worried the whole thing was going to blow, but nothing happens. John, your turn.
All right, so I'm going to, take a little break from the knives as I run up to here. Hang on one second. As I run up to there, I'm just going to throw both of my knives out to one side. And I'm going to... My mic's on, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I'm going to throw both of my knives off to the side behind me as I'm kind of moving up that way. And I'm going to pull out my whip and try and grab this guy right here around the ankle and yank him back down to the ground.
Ooh. All right. So I'm going to give you a -2 to that since he's kind of far away, so it'll be a little difficult.
Okay.
So you're looking at a 15, I think?
Yeah, 15.
Okay. That's a failure. Okay, so you send your whip out as best you can, and you know what, just because of how close it was.
I still have 4 points of words, so I'm going to burn one here.
Oh, okay. My bad. Go ahead. All right. So that's 6 damage. Roll the damage of the whip.
What was your gold number before this roll?
Mine?
Yeah.
15.
Oh, okay. I was just asking because I was wondering if that was a critical.
No. Oh, it's only one damage?
No, that's not right. I'm sorry. It's, hang on, I have to check now.
That makes sense, though, because the whip doesn't do that much damage. It's more about the range of it and how it's pretty much unblockable.
Well, it's damage 3, but I also have the shocker implant on it, so it's 3 more damage dice. And then
6.
I don't know if you feel like giving me the one for my strength. It's not, I mean, it's a melee weapon, kind of, but...
I'll give it to you because you're pulling him down to the ground. In which case, that one you just rolled counts for your strength, so then just roll the 6 that you already have. One, two, three, four.
Roll 11.
Let's roll his thing. One, two, three, four, five. Okay. So most of the damage from this is going to come from you. You wrap your whip right around his thigh, and you get it like right above his like holster for his flamethrower, and you yank him right down to the ground, and he hits his head on the way down and falls flat on his back at your feet. So he's okay. My turn.
What kind of shape is he in, out of curiosity?
He's not really that close to death. Like, he's definitely taken a beating at this point. Like, that was a very hard hit that he just took, but he's not by any means, not by any means is he going to be dying soon.
Gotcha. I'm just trying to figure out how likely it is he's going to light me up now.
Well, so I'm going to deal with Jin first. I'm going to deal with Aaron first, so I'm going to have him continuing to fight. That number that I had chosen for him was an 11, I think. It's dexterity 5 and melee 6. That's 11. Nope, still a failure. Okay, at this point, I'm going to have him... I'm going to have him slash and accidentally scratch Ella. So she actually takes a slash to the arm and like a pretty deep wound. And you can hear her cry out given how little she speaks. Then I'm going to roll for both of those men in front of you. Jin are going to be rolling for a dexterity 4 and 6, 10. That's one success and that's another success. It's not looking good.
Man.
Okay.
And I'm not wearing armor either. I just have my defense, which is
you're not wearing armor.
Aggressive.
Jin.
I don't think so.
Jin.
Unless it's heavy clothing, I don't know. I thought I had heavy clothing.
Hold on.
I
thought your battle brother robes were like super armor or something.
Hang on. That 8 is a failure, right? Because he takes the penalties.
Which penalty? He's going for a 10.
Isn't he like?
Is he still on the ground?
No, he's up.
Oh, of course he got up this time. Of course he.
No, I'm talking about the. Aren't they both like in criticals or something? So they're taking like a -4.
You're right. This guy's at a. Oh no! Wait, wrong one. All right, wait, this one. So that's okay. He's going to take a -2, and that's still a success. So the first one is still a success. The second one is at a minus. Yeah, no, he fails because he is so severely injured. Thank you for reminding me of that, Devon.
Do you have a copy of my character sheet, Liam? Because I could have sworn I put some form of armor on Jin, but I don't have any of my character.
All I have is the one roll 20. No, you would have had to buy it at the beginning. That should be on your to-do list for sure.
Yes. That's if I don't become a marshmallow.
Yeah. So we'll find out. He's going to roll is damage.
The bright side, wearing that mask might let you keep your eyebrows.
Yeah. okay.
You might get to change your avatar to the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man next episode.
Yeah, exactly. So he's gonna roll his damage. 1, 2, 3 damage.
Plus my minus 2, so. So that does that mean 5
damage? Hold on. And that's there. And then I'm also going to roll Catching on Fire. 3. There. Hold on. I'm just
going to drop and roll, Jen.
I'm doing some calculations here. Okay. So you don't get to roll your armor, right? Because you're not wearing Jin. Ah. So,
like I said, I thought I remember it, but it's not on my sheet. So,
you're going to take 9 damage.
Hey, at least I'm not dead. I have 4 left.
But you're also you're in the critical vitality levels now, and if you remember, those take a long time to heal, and now you're going to take penalties to trying to do anything.
What's the penalty?
If you're down to... How much health do you have left?
I'm down to 4 out of 13.
You have a minus 4 to anything you try to do.
So it basically just negates my aggressive stance.
Yeah, but I wouldn't do that anymore if I were you.
That's probably a good idea. Unless I manage to take one of the guys out.
Well, anyway, moving on. It is your turn, Devona.
Alright, she's gonna... She's hoping that John is...
Sorry, the guy in front of me doesn't do anything?
Ah! Ah! Sorry, I'm...
No, you already said it's Devona's turn, so it's too late.
What did Jin do?
He's going to spend the turn getting up, John. Oh, and it's Jin's turn. I thought it was Jin's turn just now, but it wasn't. It's Jin's turn now. So, Jin, what are you
going to
do?
You're welcome, Jin.
Hang on. I'm looking through my spell list.
Let's see. I just set Jin on fire, so he gets to skip a turn.
Yeah, dude, you might want to stop, drop, and roll.
Am I still on fire?
Yeah, you're on fire. If you don't do anything about it, it's until no damage is rolled. You roll 3d6 every turn to take more damage.
Yeah, I'm gonna go to, I think, full defense.
Good idea.
Yes, actually, I'm going to go to full defense.
I have to make sure that you, hold on. Give me a sec. You're going to change. Do that. Go ahead. Just looking.
And then I'm going to put the fire out, obviously.
I'm trying to check if you can do that with this kind of fire. I'm not sure you can, since it's like... If it's like spraying a kind of oil or something like that, I'm checking. But here we go. Heat fire plasma. Trying to escape a blazing building. Intensity of the fire. Burns are extremely painful, and burn victims suffer a minus 2 penalty to all goal rolls in addition to other damage penalties. So you're actually at a minus 6 right now.
I'm first going to run away.
Fair.
So I'm basically just going to run. How far can I run, like, in one turn?
25 feet.
I'm going to run to behind John. So I'm gonna hang on. Arm selectors.
So now I'm the tank.
I'm gonna run over here, and as I run, I'm gonna like roll a few times to get the fire out.
Okay, so
I did my part. I kept all the guys over there busy. I'm out of here now.
Alright, so now it is your turn, Devona.
Alright, so since Jin's fleeing and these guys are still in trouble, and she doesn't want John to get double-teamed or triple-teamed. She's going to take out this guy.
Which one? I didn't see a highlight.
The one I almost hit the tank with.
Ah. Okay, yeah, cool.
That's a better roll.
Roll, ooh, 5. Roll the damage. So that would be a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, so you hit him right in the chest, maybe even straight through his heart, but because of the fire, it's kind of hard to tell where he is because it's blazing so far and kind of growing. He has to make a roll to stay conscious. And he fails and falls to the ground unconscious. So then it's up to you, John.
All right, so I kind of tossed my Trent's knives to, you know, not have to worry about sheathing them and taking extra time to pull out my whip. But I'm going to, at this point, drop the whip and pull out my regular not trench knives.
Ooh, more knives!
Yeah, dude, I'm just like a...
Doesn't he?
I just walk around like a pen cushion, dude. And, you know, the double strike thing seem to work on the other two guys, so I'm going to hit this guy in front of me with it.
All right, so then that's going to give you a 15? Yeah. That's a failure.
Well, I still have word left, and this is it seems to be like the last big thing we're going to do before we get off planet, so...
You gonna do it? Reroll.
Absolutely, I'm gonna do it.
The luck.
Oh! Oh, that's a failure, unfortunately.
No, it's a 15. -2. That's his goal. He was a 17.
Yeah, so I don't know. Is that gonna count as a critical success since my goal number is 17?
No, because you took the -2 originally.
Right, okay.
So it's a 15 as the first one, so you're just not going to get any extra VPs. So you're going to do a 7 VP, roll the damage for your knives, which I think is 3d6 each, and you get the extra one. One there, and 3 there, so 4 plus 2, 6. 2 minus 1 equals 12, and that let me...
So you got the 6 with the 7, that's 13.
Okay, so you jam your knife right down into his skull, and he twitches and then stops moving entirely.
Perfect, that's all I wanted.
All I wanted out of life was for him to just stop. Okay, so first I'm going to make a roll to see if Brother Pietro wakes back up. Oh, he's up. He's up and moving. He gets up and, like, crawls a little closer to you, John, but I'm not sure if you see that as of right now, because you're a little preoccupied with the fact that these two gents, like, this gent is unconscious. How do I mark that?
Could I do an awareness to see if he was crawling? Because if so, that's a 4.
Yeah, sure. You can.
So I notice him getting up and moving.
Yeah, I'm going to say because John was in the middle of something he didn't notice.
Yeah, it's all the same to you, Devona. Brother Pietro is mine.
This guy's unconscious. This guy makes his way over here around the fire, and then I'm going to make a roll for Aaron. Ah, that might be a critical failure. No, it's not. Okay.
Darn you, Aaron. Do something constructive.
He fails again, and then the other man manages to kick him right in the gut, and then in dropping Endemar and Ella, slash down with a knife and get him right in the shoulder. So Aaron's not doing so great right now.
At least he got the other two released. Maybe they can dogpile him.
Maybe.
Endemar and Ella just dogpile the dude.
Okay, it's on you, Jin.
Can I, like, heal myself?
Do you have any healing equipment on you?
I don't have any healing equipment. Is there not any sort of roll or skill?
If you have the spell, then yes, but if not, no. You would need a med pack of some sort, which I think Devona has, and the skill physic to heal yourself.
Devona, do you have a med pack?
Yes, I do. I have a surgical kit, actually.
Ooh. I've got a physics kit, which is better.
So I'm hit, like, really hard, so I'm, like, on my knees, kind of leaning on my staff, and I reach up and I just wave madly at Devona, like, help me, please.
Help me, for the love of God, help me.
She's going to give you a thumbs up and it's like, yeah, once the fight's over.
Okay, so,
I'm just not doing anything, I'm just defending. Full defense. You're just,
okay, cool. Then Devona, up to you.
She's going to acknowledge Jen and be like, once we're out of danger, I'll patch you up. And let's see. This guy is fighting Indemar, right?
He's fighting Aaron.
Aaron, sorry. I'm going to try to shoot this guy.
So you're shooting that guy that's fighting Aaron?
Yeah, because she sees that Aaron is losing the battle, and John has been showing that he is very good at fighting. She can figure he can take on the two weaklings.
That's an 11. That converts to 5 VP. Roll your damage.
7. So...
Plus
12. 10. So 12 damage towards the guy fighting Aaron.
Hold on. We're not there yet. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So I'm going to turn this piece of paper over here. He takes a healthy shot. Just in a leg. It knocks him to the ground, but then Aaron gets a nice slash on him. Jams his knife into his shoulder.
Finally, he does something.
And I'm just copying my notes here on what these guys are up to. Yes. Okay. All right. So... John, it's your turn.
All right, quick question. Hypothetically speaking, if I were to move, like, here. Hang on.
Where?
Right there.
Mm-hmm.
Would I be able to get this guy from behind?
He would turn to face you.
Okay.
But you can push him in the fire.
Yeah, just run inside, kick him into the fire.
Yeah, he's got the fireproof robe thing, so I'm not sure that's a... Plus, he's got a flamethrower, doesn't he?
Well, I'm not sure how well flame retardant stuff works when you're in a fire. Like, sitting in a fire. Like, flame retardant kind of goes out the window.
Not entirely.
That was going to be my finishing move on Brother Pietro, anyways. I was saving the good part for last. All right, I'm going to move up here and double knife him again. Double knife this guy.
Woo! Okay.
Jin had his day. Now it's John going all Rambo on people.
Your goal number was what now? 15, right?
15.
Okay, so that's going to be 7 VP for you. Roll your damage with just your regular knives. So that's 3d6 each plus 1 more for each. So close. Okay. So 1, 2, 3. 2 more is 5. Let me roll this. Where is my mouse? There we go.
Yeah, I don't think I need to re-roll either of those. He's not looking so hot anyways, right?
One second. I'll tell you in a moment that he is hella dead.
Not just dead, but hella dead.
Oh, he's hella dead. how do you tell us? What do you do?
All right, so you guys have seen like the kung fu movies where the guy like claps somebody on the side of the head to stun him, right?
Yeah,
yeah.
Kind of like that, but with fists, and my knives are in my fists.
Oh,
so,
it's like right through.
It's
each
like
ear.
The brain surgery from Mortal Kombat.
Yeah,
Mylena's whole thing.
I just really want to get strong enough that I can like smack someone like that, and you know, make their head explode like in that movie, The Story of Ricky.
Cool, cool. All right. So then we move on to my turn. Oh, he's out. All right. So,
the wolf. We have the guy that Aaron just stabbed in the shoulder. We have Brother Pietro's crawling slowly towards us, and then the other guy's unconscious.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So roll this d20. This is a goal number of 11 for... Right? 11? I was looking at the wrong guy. 11. Nope. All right. No bueno.
Fucking Aaron, man.
You know, he's not a trained fighter at all. No muster. But anyway, I digress. So, excuse me. This other guy is... So Pietro is up, and he's... he seems to have recovered himself a little bit. And he, what does he have?
Is he going to try and come for the wounded guy? That sounds like what he would do.
So, John, he looks at you. And I'm assuming you notice him. And he kind of makes eye contact with you and very slowly walks around the fire until he makes eye contact with you on this side. Then he walks forward, stepping on the head of his unconscious man as he goes. And he moves slowly towards you, flame gun drawn. And there's a moment of pure silence. And then he fires.
You hear a Western song going on?
Yeah, exactly. Like, like that song from Django and Chain.
Whatever that song is.
Or yeah. No, Fistful of Dollars. Fistful of Dollars from,
That soundtrack would be by Ennio Morricone.
What's the name of the movie? Oh my god, Clint Eastwood movie.
Yeah, you're thinking of Fistful of Dollars.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, anyway, that's playing. Moving on. So he takes a shot, and this is goal number here.
I'm sure he's got some hefty penalties on that, though.
Nothing too hefty. Your chagrin, I'm sure, but his goal number is 8-9. And that is not what he gets. So he fires his flame gun, and then after he sees you, I'm assuming you try and dodge that, you know, like take a small lunge back, and he...
Yeah, roll out of the way, something.
Okay, and he points his flame thrower right down into the flames beside him. And then, Jin, we're skipping you, and Devona, it's your turn.
So I'm gonna shoot this guy again.
Okay. So, have at it.
Oh!
That is critical success. Oh, that is a lot of VP. That's 9 and 8. That's 17 VP right off the bat. Give me a damage
roll.
Holy
shoot.
That guy is ultra hella dead.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And what I'm really interested in is, could you kill him twice over? Oh, you can. Sorry, but you just hear, and his head explodes onto Aaron's face, and he just shouts out in horror.
No, I was going to do something else.
Oh, sorry. If you were going to do something else, go on. I just always took an immediate death of a headshot. Go on.
I'm going to do a sniper elite to ball shot.
Where are you? You're going ball shot?
Ball shot.
Nice. All right.
Dude, you don't shoot people in the balls. That's not cool.
So, like, his crotch just suddenly explodes all over Aaron.
And Aaron's like, and he falls forward onto Aaron. John, your turn.
I can't Very believe nice. It. I was so close to getting the first critical of the game.
Alright, so I'm going to move here. And, okay, so I'm not sure exactly how this is going to work. I want to slash him with my knife, but all I really want to do is, like, cut his robes open and then kick him back into the fire.
Okay, so that would just be a knockdown, and we'll just stylize it.
Well, if we're going for a knockdown, would it be better to switch to my other combat style?
I would say it's too late to switch anyway.
Alright, so what do I do for a knockdown here?
So, it would be dexterity or strength, choose, and then fight or athletics, again, choose.
And dexterity. So that gives me a 16.
You're doing dexterity and what? Are you doing fight or athletics? Say what? John?
I can't hear you, John.
Hello?
Ah, there you go.
Okay. Yeah, it's definitely going to be fight because I don't have much of anything in athletics.
So dex and fight, you say?
Yeah, which gives me a 16.
Cool. Okay, so roll that. Dex and fight for him is going to be... Uh-oh. Does Brother Pietro not have fight?
Uh-oh.
Oh, no, he does. He does. Just kidding. Just kidding. Yeah, he does. He does. Don't worry, guys. Just in case you're worried.
I don't think we were actually worried.
Right. Okay. Well, anyway, his goal number is a 10. Oh! Okay. That's super unfortunate for you, John. Okay, so...
Wait. Is it too late to spend, like, one of my last two remaining points of word and reroll that?
Hang on. He's critical. He's got penalties.
You're right. He fails. John.
Nice.
Didn't. Okay, so
nice,
you slash.
Devona.
So you slash him open.
Devona's
I
saving
slash
everybody.
His, okay, so I slash his robes open. And I look at him dead in the eye for just a split second. I'm like, you like to play with fire? And then I Sparta kick him into the fire.
Ooh. All right. So now he needs to roll. Right off the bat, he needs to roll a solid 5d6 for damage. He gets 1, 2, 3. Let's get a rack up there. And then he gets 3 more damage for the fact that he's on fire. So that's... He gets to roll his robes now against fire is 10d6. Oh no, John, I'm so sorry, but he's so okay. He's so perfectly fine.
Wait, cutting his robes open didn't do anything to change it?
Oh, you did cut his robes open though. I'm sorry. So I'm
gonna the whole point.
I'm sorry, that was my mistake. Then I'm just gonna take away the last 3. So then he loses 3 of his successes. But he still... He He still only takes one.
He is, like, in the fire now.
He is in the fire, yes. And he shouts really... He screams out in pain once you kick him in the fire.
He's knocked down in the fire.
That is true. He has lost defense. That's why he got... It was originally going to be... Because you were at 5 damage for the fire, but then he gained one more for his defense, and then he had 5 successes, and so he lost that, and so he only had 1 damage.
Would my kick do any damage?
No.
No, you were doing a knockdown that does no damage.
So
right, fair enough.
So he's in the fire. He's gonna move to cover himself with his robes and then point his flame gun out at you, John, and try and shoot at you. He's not even gonna attempt to roll out of the fire. What's his shoot? 7, dex 4, 11. Ah! Alright, so he fires his flame gun out at you, but to no avail, as you see flames burst forth from the fire as he's screaming, but nothing comes of it. Jin, we're skipping you, I assume. Devona, are you going to do anything?
Oh, I don't know. I was actually considering getting back in.
Oh, Jin, are you going to do something?
Now that everybody's dead, yeah.
Yeah, I was considering getting back into it.
All right, you want to do
it?
Is
the guy still unconscious, the other guy who's on the ground?
He's dead now.
Oh, he's dead now. Okay.
Brother Pietro stepped on his head and cracked his skull. I mean, he's still alive right now, but not for long.
Quick, do your last rites before what's-his-face comes and eats him.
Hang on, I have to look. I have to check something. I'm looking at the rule book real quick.
Okay.
Let's see. That's what it is. I think I'm going to use my rightfully guided hand, my ability. Let's see. What is it? How do I do that? How do I cast that right? It's a faith plus chosen combat skill.
Wait, I'm sorry.
And
then where,
cast one word.
Where are you in the rule book?
I'm at the brother battle skills. Basically, what I'm going to do is.
No, so I know where it is, but like, what page are we talking?
Hang on. It's page 227. And what I was going to do was switch from full defense to full aggression, just to get that +4 bonus that on the gate. You know, the penalties against me right now. And so let's see, I'm switching up to here. And I'm just going to charge. Can I attack on the diagonal with these squares?
Yeah, right? Yeah.
I'm just going to charge at the guy who's there. And I'm going to use my rightfully guided hand.
Oh, sorry.
More like here?
Yeah, no, he's in the fire.
Oh, yeah, well, I'm there then. I'm where I am now.
Okay.
So I'm at my standard 15, and then I'm going to use rightfully guided hand to increase that if I can. I just want to make sure how I roll that and see if it successes.
So you call on the pan creator to steady your hand. A theorist can add the victory points from the casting of the strike to the goal number of the combat skill rolls, minimum +1. Yeah, so you'd spend a word, and roll faith plus the chosen combat skill.
So let's see. Faith is 7 plus melee is 7, so I'm at 14. And I get but the penalty's negated because I'm still an aggressive. So that's plus the goal number. And so slash roll.
So 14?
20. Yeah, 14's a goal number. 12.
Ooh, nice. All right, so 6 VP are being added onto your role. How are you envisioning this? Like, does your hand start glowing? Do you hear a voice? What's up?
Basically, I start going like my whole translucent thing where I look like a ghost. And yeah, I guess my hands start glowing. And that means my goal number is 21.
Before Jin finishes off, she wants to shout at Brother Pietro.
What?
Technology is the gift of the Pan Creator, you blasphemous scum.
It's like just as I bring my Naginata down on him.
So that's like the last words he hears.
You couldn't just let him burn and let me have this one, huh?
Well, hold on. So, Jin, you still have to roll your attack. Make sure it hits.
That's what I just did. It was the 4.
Oh, I didn't see the 4 pop yet. My bad. So that's 2. Now roll the damage of the Naginata.
So that's a 10. 10d6.
Oh, and Jin. Wait, and Jin, also, you need to speak in order to use this. So what do you say? Because we'd spoken about the fact that you sometimes need to speak to do your rights. You need to speak for this. So what do you say?
I'm going to whisper, like a spirit whisper, taste despair.
Ooh. All right.
As I bring this giant blade down on him. That's 8 successes.
Oh, boy. All right. Hold on. I'm going to give him the benefit of his armor. See what happens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. Yeah, no, you still did enough to kill him. So you bring your blade down on him and slice him open.
Or I'm going to roleplay that out. So he's in the fire, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to say, taste despair, bring my blade down on him. It gets stuck in him. I'm going to drag him out of that by the blade that's stuck in him. And so drag him out of the fire.
Mm-hmm.
And then bring my Naginata down on his head and slice his head off. So I drag him out, yank him to the ground, and smack his head off.
All right.
And then I promptly go down to my knees again.
Okay.
Like hands and knees.
All right. He is done. And there's, you know, the moment of silence after the heat of the battle where everyone is just panting and standing there. I'll give you the benefit of the doubt, John. You can speak first since it was your initiative turn next.
It was difficult.
Look at Jen and I'm like, did you say something?
I look at him. I just kind of stare at him for a second. And then I let my head drop again.
So, while they're doing that little thing, Devona comes down and picks up the little charge pack.
Hey, that's mine, don't forget. I'm going to go and use a physic kit to tend to Ella's wound. I got to look out for my investment here.
Of course.
She's going to heal Jin.
Give me a physic roll, both of you.
Just straight physic?
No, with the physic.
Well, that did not work because my goal number was a 9.
All right, so you try and help Ella out, but just kind of botch it a little bit. But she's not that badly hurt anyway.
I mean, mostly what I was looking to do was bandage it.
Yeah, you can do that, but you don't do anything else exceptional. She's still pretty injured as far as the extent of it. She's just not bleeding anymore. Devona, what was your goal number?
12. You see the 1 success?
Well, I don't know why it says 1 success, though. Oh, because you did the less than 12 thing. But it's not, I mean, it's not 1 success. It's whatever. It's 1 point for your health, Jin.
Huh. Wonderful. I got 1 health point back.
I think everyone's going to be resting for a hot second once this is over.
yeah, I'm going to go pick up my knives and take my battery back from Devona.
What is this battery for? Is it for a shield generator?
It's actually for my shock implant on my whip.
Oh, okay. She's wanting to try to get a shield generator battery pack, though. Now she's got the pieces to make a shield generator.
So, and I'm gonna look at Aaron, and I'm gonna be like, "Dude, you gotta be careful damaging other people's property like that."
He chuckles to himself and says, "My apologies. I just wanted to make sure she stayed alive and didn't get, you know, strangled and all."
I'm just gonna sit there, like sitting down.
Okay.
So,
my pole on the ground next to me.
So last time, when you were describing the scene, there was the fire, there was the crowd, there was the Avestites, there was Aaron and Ella and Endemar, and you said there were a couple of crates that hadn't been burned yet.
There was only ever one crate that was had tech being burned.
Is anything still in that crate?
Okay, so you walk over to the crate and roll it. And I'm gonna roll to see how much is in it. How do I want to roll this? Give me a minute. Discuss among yourselves on something. Let me just think.
Good job, John. You killed how many? Three.
Plus
kicking Petro into the fire.
Yeah, it would have been at least four if you'd let me finish him off.
Nah, I wanted to get a good kill in. I wanted to get a kill in.
What are you talking about? You got like two kills in.
I got one kill in.
I think I burned all of my word except for one point though.
Well, hey, we're gonna be resting and everything, so I guess you get it back when you rest, right?
That is true.
Yeah, like 8 hours of sleep and you get 1 point back, something like that. So as long as we have like a week or so of downtime, it should be good.
After this, I have a few things in mind, by the way, about combat. So there's a way to make combat less deadly, which is instead of VPs turning directly into wounds, they're going to turn into dice. All of combat is going to be less deadly, which means it'll be harder for you to kill things, but it'll also be a lot less dangerous for you to be involved in battle, which means you won't get a shotgun blast in the face and nearly die like John.
Why can't it be you won't get blasted by a flamethrower and set on fire like Jin?
Sorry. It's just that was real close to Jeff. Jin had like 4 health. You had 1.
Yeah, I know. That really sucked for me.
And also, I'm enforcing the healing thing from now on, which is critical vitality levels, which means anything from 1 to 5 takes a month to heal, and anything above that takes a week to heal. Every single point takes a week.
Oh, wow. I got really roughed up, didn't I? I need a doctor.
You got one. Unfortunately, that's as much as anyone can heal you.
I'm stuck at 5 VP for the next month.
I mean, I could give it a shot, but my goal number is like a 9, so, you know.
I'm talking like resting in a hospital. That's how healing works. Here, wait, I'll just read you the thing. Let me find it. It's under combat, I think. No, it's not.
Healing, what about like resting on a ship or like at home
It's right here. So critical vitality levels are 1 a month, further vitality levels are 1 a week. Within 10 minutes after the wound has been inflicted, a character can attempt or receive first aid to prevent the wound from worsening. Receiving medical treatment from a proper doctor with access to medicines and such greatly improves the speed. A successful hospital or similar treatment will result in the patient recovering one non-critical vitality level a day and 1 critical every week. So that's a lot faster.
So if I went to a hospital, it would be a lot faster.
What is your health right now?
5, because Devona healed me for 1.
Okay, so you don't have to heal any of your critical vitality levels. So it normally, naturally, it would take you 8 weeks, but it would take you 8 days in a hospital.
Well, good thing we're heading to Rampart. Hopefully we can find a hospital there.
Oh, maybe we just rest. I mean, we don't even know how long this is going to take us to get there.
Okay, so, anyway, after the battle has died down, you can hear the shouting of what remains of the Mantis Knights trying to figure out what the disturbance is over here, coming from somewhere else. So, what do you guys want to do?
I say we grab that crate and... I mean, Mama Jazzy seems like it's been her go-to, but I don't know if the Avestites are onto that one.
Aaron steps forward and says, guys, I think it's really about time we get the hell off planet.
You got a ship?
I don't got a ship, but I'm sure we can find a way to get one. With a lot less time than it would take. I think given the moon situation and the... and he murmurs and points down to the ground at the dead man next to him, Avestite situation, that we should really put our energies into getting off planet as soon as possible.
Yeah, but we should take this crate if there's anything in it.
Yeah. Isn't there still the that one ship, Pancreator's Justice or whatever it was called?
Pancreator's Torch. No, it left.
Okay.
And Aaron slaps himself in the side of the head and says, right! And he suddenly lunges down to the crate and rips it open with a justice and jams his hands in and pulls out a few different things. And he says, like, a lot of these are luxury pieces, but they go for a good sum of money. But then he, like, digs all the way to the bottom and pulls out this large cylindrical thing and says, this is what we're looking for. And he looks up at you, John, with, like, the widest smile a man can have, the widest smile you've ever seen him crack. And he says, this is a jump key.
I thought he had a jump key.
He, as an engineer, may have had one, but you never discussed it with him.
All right, well, let's find a ship. Let's get the rest of this stuff and find a ship, man.
So he... think for a second, hold on. So he points to Jin and says, can you pick that up? Follow me. And he, like, dashes off into the spaceport.
How heavy is the crate?
Not that heavy. It's like a quarter full.
Wait, did you just tell me to pick it up?
I'll grab the crate. I'm, you know, unscathed from this particular fight.
One second. Holy charges now to make the key. Usual fate, we're looking at junkies. Hold on a second. I'm just looking at the jump key situation. Okay. So. One second, I'm sorry. Aaron is pushing his way through this through the very crowded spaceport. What little ships there are like, you know, dashing around and whatnot. And, you see inside the spaceport, so it's, like I'd mentioned, a long hallway, but then it kind of ends in a large circle, and at the edges of the circle, there are just ships everywhere, and a lot of them are taking off, and there are people fighting every which way. Excuse me. People fighting everywhere, making their best effort, trying to get passage onto ships. Most of them are, like, already half taking off. There's a lot of people pushing their ways onto ships, and there's one ship that you notice is not being fought over, but is instead actually just occupied by one man sitting at the bottom of like his ramp, and he's dressed kind of like he's an older man. I'm gonna say like late 60s, and he's sitting at the bottom of his ramp. Smoking a cigar with a gigantic trench knife, the style of yours, John, held at his side, in almost as like a warning to anyone that comes near him. That's the only thing that sticks out to you besides the kind of indescript people every which way that are just fighting over passage on ships.
All right, I'm going to walk over to him. Non-threatening. Just walking. And be like, is this your ship?
He looks up at you and says, what's it to you?
Looks like you might need a pilot.
I'd love a pilot. And he like looks over at Aaron and says, but that doesn't solve all of my problems. And he stands up and says, why? You commandeering my vessel? And he like holds his, and he kind of like pulls his knife up a little bit, not actually attacking you, just kind of like making sure that you're aware he's holding it.
I'm going to set the crate down gently and pull out both of my knives and say, look, we don't have time to necessarily solve all your problems. You've got a ship. We've got a pilot. You do the math. We can do this easy. We can do this hard.
We can't do this at all without a fucking jump key.
We have that.
Just happens to be your lucky day because we got one of those too.
He looks at you really suspicious, and now I'm going to have you roll presence and influence, John. What's your goal number?
11.
Woo! Roll that baby again. Oh! Alright. So, immediately, he sheaths his knife. Flicks one of yours, like, playfully almost, and says, I'd recognize those anywhere, and maybe you've recognized mine. And he, like, puts his hand tightly around your shoulder, like, very forceful. Not actually an attack or anything like that, but he's just, like, very camaraderie, and he says, you're a member of the muster. I was like you at one point in my life as well. Get on the ship. And he, like, turns around and he starts making his way up the ship. Not at a very fast clip, since he's
As soon as he says that, I'll be like, old man, you're all right, but there ain't nobody like me.
He smiles and chuckles to himself and says, get on the ship, let's go. And starts walking up. All right,
pick up the gull, sheath my knives, pick up the crate, and everybody, let's get on this fucking ship.
Okay, so everyone's on the ship. And the older man moves to the front of the ship, and shows you the cockpit. And Aaron like rushes forward and he says, "I've flown one of these before. No worries, I've got it under control." And he sits behind the wheel, or the, whatever you want to call it, the controls. And he says, "There's no med bay on this ship, but the bunks are relatively nice. I'd suggest that you guys go rest. We've got a little bit of time before we have anything serious going on." And then, as he says that, you hear, like, knocking on the outside of the ship.
But do a head count. I mean, do we have everybody, Santino, Ella?
Yeah, everyone's on the ship.
Then, yeah, let's just take off. Who gives a fuck who's knocking?
Okay. I never took the time to describe it, actually. But this is a very small ship, kind of like a scout. Definitely large enough to get into space and go through jump gates, but pretty much the bare minimum for that. We're talking like more or less like an Explorer shuttle type. One second, I'm sorry. I'm just... Ship's situation. Each ship with an impression... I'm sorry, I'm just looking at... there's something that I'm not understanding what it means... Oh, okay, I see. I'm sorry, I haven't really looked much at the at the classifications of ships. I'll do that later. But for right now, it's a rather small ship, pretty much just big enough to accommodate you guys. Imagine sort of like the ship, if you guys have seen Rogue One, kind of like that one.
There were a lot of ships in that.
Right. No, I mean the main one that they use, like at the beginning.
That like a transport shuttle kind of thing?
Yeah, and it had like a small, it had like seats in the back, and then there were like a few bunks on the upper level.
Gotcha.
So it's like just large enough. The weapons are not too fancy.
Well, hopefully we're not going to need those, because I don't know about Jen and Devona, but I can't shoot for shit.
Right, so.
Unfortunately, I don't think I can shoot, because I think ship cannons would count like as artillery or something.
So, immediately Aaron takes off and makes a turn and starts, bolting out of the planet. And so, looking back down as you make your way out, you can see crowds just rioting every which way. And looking up, you can see Everlight above you, massive and vast. And as you fly outward towards, Aaron has a grip on where the jump gate lies, makes his way out, and you can see like almost the fires lighting around the city, the riots, and it's true terror, unlike anything you've ever seen. But there's nothing you can do now. So.
Except have a drink.
The old man says, I'll act as your navigator, and claps Aaron on the back and sits down next to him. Before he puts on like his headset and gets to work, he turns to you, John, and extends his hand out. Holy shit, I haven't thought of a name. Give me 10 seconds. He extends his hand and says, Ellis, nice to meet you.
John Havelock, likewise.
He turns around and starts working the navigational systems, helping out Aaron in every way he can, trying to make sure that everything goes smoothly. I'm assuming the rest of you are going to want to go rest for a little bit.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm going to have a quick word with Ella first, but shortly thereafter, definitely.
Okay, have at it. What do you want to say to her?
Be like, so you realize that I just saved your life back there. And
she nods.
After purchasing you and then saving your life, that means that your life is mine twice over.
She nods and says, there's little else I can owe you.
I'm going to give her one of my knives. Not my trench knife, but my regular knife.
Mm-hmm.
And be like, I'm going to trust you not to stick this in my neck while I'm sleeping. But next time someone tries to grab you, stick it in them.
She nods and smiles widely.
Next time when we get some downtime, I'll show you how to use that good and proper.
So, the ship is making its way off planet, and if you guys are unaware of how the jump gates work, does anyone not know, or is everyone aware how jump gates work?
I mean, I have a vague idea, but
I'm thinking either like Stargate style or Mass Effect style.
I don't remember if it's Mass Effect style, actually. How does that go?
You line up to the relay, and it railguns you forward.
No. Okay, hold on. I think there's an actual FAQ that explains it properly, because I don't want to botch it.
But I'm really thinking it's more like, I've seen a lot of games with it where it's kind of just a circular device. It opens up, it activates, and you go in, and you're at a different destination.
Yeah, that's a lot closer. So,
wormholes and Stargate style.
Okay, so after you are a fair distance, we're talking like 1,000 feet, like regular, not 1,000 feet. What am I saying? What's the height at which airlines like generally cruise? Is that 1,000 feet?
No, that's like between 30,000 and 50,000.
10,000 feet. That's what I was thinking. Where they turn off the turn off the seatbelt sign. That's what I was thinking of. Jesus, had a stroke there. Anyway, so around 10,000 feet, the world is tiny beneath you, and Aaron is accelerating constantly for the half of this like trip. Generally speaking, it takes about a few hours until you are well off the planet, and then he turns off. You can hear the engines like turn off, and you continue to drift, obviously, but there's a slight jolt as they turn off. Do any of you actually question how this works, or do you just all kind of rest?
As far as I'm concerned, it's magic.
Vona probably would try to investigate and wanting to know how it works.
Okay. So generally speaking, if you're not aware of how jump gates work, they take you, so they open up, there's like a code on each jump key, and it's transmitted to the charioteers that run the jump gate. Because this jump gate is in evacuation mode, they are opening up, and since the Pandemonium jump gate only goes to two other planets, and one of them is a Val planet, they're mostly keeping the jump gate open for they're generally keeping the jump gate open to get to Rampart. And so there's a very long line of ships that are trying to get off planet, but many of them are going at the same time. So you are staying, more or less staying in this line close to the jump gate, which if you look at it is, as you've seen, I'm assuming in your past, but I'm explaining to you now, is almost... I think it's 1,000 meters is the proper measurement that they gave. The radius is about 500 kilometers. So diameter, we're talking about 1,000 kilometers. And it opens up, and on the other side, you can see the planet of Rampart. And so many are going at the same time. And as you finally pull up after like another 12, after about a few hours, because the jump gate resets every time another group jumps through, it actually takes, it actually takes about, so after every time the jump gate is opened, it's open for like a short period of time, at which point they can all go through, but because there are charioteers are aware of this emergency situation, usually after it closes, it has to reset, and that takes between a second and a day, and the average is about 11 hours. You guys are looking at a long time here, but because the charioteers are aware of what an emergency situation it is, they're pretty much constantly resetting over and over. They're using a special reset key that they have that just resets it instantly every time another one jumps in. And so it actually takes you a record amount of time to get through, pretty much about like half an hour. And you just finally make your way through the jump gate, and you see Rampart off in the distance. They pull through the jump gate and then decelerate on their way to the planet. And pulling into Rampart, Aaron turns around to Jin and asks you, do you have any preference as to where we're going? I've heard that this is your home planet.
I look at him, and I just kind of shake my head, because it's been a long time.
Okay. I'm also going to throw this in as kind of the teaser of the next mission, because we're going to end soon. John, during this time while you were waiting in line at the jump gate, do you have any special, equipment that would let you communicate with people?
I mean, I've got my, I don't know, I forget what it's called. Hang on a second. I've got my Squawker headset, which is like typically short range communication. It's basically like a walkie talkie.
No. Okay. So then, you pull, okay. So then never mind. You can't be communicated with, but you pull down, out onto the purview of Rampart. And Rampart, I'm not going to send you the picture, but it's essentially two very, very large subterranean, not subterranean, sorry. What's the one looking for? Whatever. Two large continents. One that's kind of like, it kind of forms a V, the two of them put together. And you can see that Aaron is pulling onto the... to the right side of it, and he looks at Jin as if expecting him to do the talking, but then thinks otherwise of it, pointing out at the continents. He says, "That to the left is Ymera. Most of that is pretty much Li Halen controlled. Not such a great idea for us to go there. I think a better idea would be to make for the guild sectors." And he points to the right side, and he says, "That's called Delest. There's a city all the way on the eastern side of that continent that's controlled by the Muster. Down in the southwest is also one controlled by the engineers. Any preference for you guys?"
Engineers.
I mean, I know where I'd like to go.
Well, you know, Jin is Li Halen, so...
but... the man... Ellis cuts you off and says, "I have business in Safria. Go there." And that, and he points to it and says, "That's the Muster-controlled city." So Aaron nods his head and says, "All right," and pulls his way over that way. A long while more passes before finally, I'll say that you guys are all like asleep up in your bunks when Aaron comes up and says, "Wakey wakey, all you, it's time, let's get out here." And he pulls you off the ship, down the ramp, and at the bottom of the ramp, there's actually a messenger waiting, and he sees you coming off the ship, John, and he runs up to you and says, "John Havelock?"
"Who's asking?"
"Lieutenant DeWitt Stark," and that's the name of your superior officer, by the way. Oh no, sorry. Mark Teslin is the name of your superior officer. Your superior officer, Mark Teslin, has sent me. He's like your really much superior.
So does he, like, is it like a written message?
Yeah, it would be a written message.
Alright, what's it say?
So he hands it to you, and he opens it up, and says, "Dear John, I owe a favor to a good friend of mine. That I'd like to cash in, and I think that you would be best suited for the job because I hear that you're on your way to Rampart. He makes his base there at Safria, but I'm assuming since you're reading this message, you're there already. His name is DeWitt Stark," and he like has a little address at the bottom of the paper of where to find him. "He has a job for you. I think it's something you could handle. Sincerely," with a little smiley face, "Mark Teslin. Lieutenant Mark Teslin."
Did he dot the I with the heart and stuff, too?
Of course, of course.
"Well, ladies and gentlemen, I at least have some work to do here, but I think a couple of days in a infirmary somewhere might do us all a little bit of good."
So, I'm going to deal with... So let's deal with the healing, see how that goes, and then after... And when you also, I'm just going to throw in this little bit of, when you guys jump off of the ship. So you're in the city of Safria, which is I'm trying to find the description of it. Right. I just had it. Um, One second. Oh, I don't. That's annoying. One second. All right, there's no description here, but whatever. So when you walk off the when you walk off of the ship, it's rather pleasant here. Very different from what you'd experienced on Pandemonium, because that was a pretty depressing world. It's pretty pleasant. It's sunny. You know, with the terraforming and all that's been going on here, it's pretty Earth-like. And it's kind of, if it's similar to like Florida almost, like imagine you're getting off the plane in Florida. It's temperate, not too hot, not too cold. There are mountains all around you can see. And there are actually birds flying all around, the kind of thing that you, again, did not see on Pandemonium. But the city itself is industrious, but not overly so. It seems to be almost like a New York City type of thing. Controlled by the muster, however, is a lot more, it's a lot rougher. So consider like Brooklyn in the 80s. That's my description for you of that. But as far as if you guys want to find an infirmary or like a doctor, you can certainly find it. Given the high tech level of the planet, it's actually pretty damn nice. So do you guys want to spend some time in an infirmary?
Yes.
Yeah, I think that's probably for the best.
All right.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I'm going to be useless until I get some armor.
I think we all took some hits.
But I'm going to buy some armor, and I think I'm going to buy a revolver just to give myself some ranged capability.
You're going
to
buy a revolver?
I'm thinking about it.
Okay.
Although I'll need the slug gun skill. So.
All right, so give me one second. Okay, so you all get to stay in a hospital by at a maximum of the VP scored on the wits plus physical role of the doctor. So I'm assuming that you all have the same doctor attending. His stats are right here. His goal number is a 16. All right, this is for this is based on the initiative order, is Devona first. So Devona, you can stay for 2 days. So that's, I think that's just two right off the bat for you, right? Which, how much did you need to heal?
I needed, I have six. I needed, four more.
Okay. So you get two of them back, and then you still have two more you need. This is for Jin. Again, the goal number is 16. Jin, you can stay for 4 days. So you get four more of your VP back. And John, this is for you. You can stay for 3 days. I'm assuming you all want to stay for your maximum amount?
Yes.
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 Okay. So so at the start of our next session, Devona is going to be out and about for 1 day before John can come in, and then John's going to be out for one more day before Jin can come in.
Now, me walking around the city and it's muster controlled, I'm not going to get grabbed and try to be sold, am I?
No, probably not. That's not how they work. They generally, as far as grabbing and selling people, it's generally like serfs. Pandemonium was an exception.
Okay.
Yeah, plus I'm sure they followed the golden rule about not shitting where you live.
Of course. So, anyway.
I mean, if they just snatch people off the streets in their own cities, then no one would ever go to those cities.
Exactly. So, anyway, that's the end of our session for now. But you're on a much more pleasant planet than you were last time. And I have a fun adventure in store for you guys. Still got to work out the kinks, but it's looking good. What do you guys think?
I liked it.
Sweet. It was good.
It feels like a satisfactory conclusion.
All right, cool. You'll hear the news about what happens on Pandemonium in the future. So what actions you took over the next few days, you'll hear tell of what happened.
Oh, really?
In fact, I'll start off the next session with that, because I think 2 days is a satisfactory enough time for the dust to settle over there. So, as far as experience goes, okay, so I'm going to give you guys one for playing. You get another there because you finished the campaign, not the campaign, the adventure. And just going through here, you guys are getting a good amount. Okay, you guys are going to get 7 XP.
Nice.
And it's that. All right, so I guess I'll see you guys next week then.
All right. See you later, man.
Yep,
man.
Good for me. Good session, right. Guys. I got to run, though. I got to get to sleep.
Yeah, yep. Fair enough. All right, I'll talk to you guys later.
Later.
Bye-bye.
Bye.